But you know, you probably followed first, and all I saw was Japanese characters. In chat, I see Artie. But if it's just a follow, it's hi, Japanese characters. I finally saw it. Took him a while. Alright, so where we are, we still want to get across that stupid bridge, and we just gave the dynamite to this guy that we want to use to blow up the bridge. He's like, let me have that. And I'm like, no. And he's like, snatch. Well, we want to blow up the door to the bridge, not the whole bridge. K.O. Fiveton. So now we have no idea where to go. We definitely need to sleep. Welcome back. We missed all the Camelot. You missed coldest winter night. You missed wander. Silently we wander. Search of truth and something. It's in search of truth and confidence. Now we can play now that you're here, we can play Camel Sauce. That's right. So now we have no idea where to go whatsoever. Maybe we can go get some more soup from Martha. I mean, really, I have four locations. I have this location. I have the priest, where I just got the dynamite from. I've got Martha with the soap. And I've got the stone bridge. And I've been to the bridge so many times. Just stepping on that dead guy, it's fine. Better cutscene me as soon as I walk out of this house. Nope. I guess we're walking. Going to Martha's house. Get some more soup. That's literally the only way to go. Except all the way. No, it's over here. Except all the way around to the stupid fucking bridge again. So do not want to go over there again. And be like, no, no, you're not supposed to be here. Nope, sorry. Wrong again. If I have to do that, I'm checking a guide to see whether or not that's what I need to do. I'm done walking over there for no reason. I'm unwilling. I got in like 2.5 hours of steps yesterday. What's up, Johnny? What am I done with? Am I going the right way? I'm done walking. I'm so tired of walking in the snow. Sick of this shit. I've played way too much D2. Well, there's a lot of things I'd rather do than play 8 hours of Valve at Assassin. Like, eat a hamburger. If only. Or Diablo 2. It's time to shoot some birds. Where the fuck are they? There they are. Hello, motherfucker. No, she has a portable cooker. Automatically skins and cooks it for you. You just put a rabbit in there and it comes out as perfectly cooked meat. Zorn, so can win his Valve at Assassin? Never. I don't even like good stealth games. Hard stream with a D2 type monster? Wow. I need some more soup. Beef's good. I like Assassin's Creed for stealth games. She's not here, good. That means something has changed. That means we're supposed to be here, which is fantastic. She did. What the fuck?
Wait, I'm okay now. You must believe me.
What?
That sorcerer deceived me. He was just using me. Please believe me.
Where the fuck are you?
I know I turned into a monster, but I'm okay now. I've got my mind back. And see, my body's back to normal, too. Even if my blood's green, I'm still a human being. Is that what you want to kill? Come on, trust me. Both human, aren't we? It's okay. You can trust me.
You've been eating green jello or something?
See, trust me.
Oh, ah!
I'm still human. No, you're not. Kill it. Quit moving around, you little fuck. Retro Bear,
thanks for making me human again. We were wrong.
It's more like a rail shooter.
The sorcerer was just using us and didn't know it.
All the action is rail shooter.
Linda, you gave us got on that plane. It felt like bees were flying around in our skulls. Don't remember anything else, just the buzzing. The buzzing in my head.
Stand in one place, rail shooter.
He says he's fusing with the shadow, becoming one with him, to get the power to destroy the world. Said that the shadow's been asleep in Death Mountain up north for 65 million years. Now the meteor woke it up. You've got to stop him. Now that I've turned into this thing, now I realize that I've wasted.
Might be, actually. No, well, I think it's from a Fallout game, maybe.
My wasted life.
Fallout or Postal? Yeah, it might be Postal. Postal 2. Hi, Hunter Blair.
Feels kind of good. Thanks.
Sure. Not that eye, though. I'm just closing these ones. No, don't do it.
I'm not doing this. No.
You perished. That'd be fucked
Laura.
Up.
Laura. Laura Parton.
Laura Parton?
I am the great mother.
Is that her name?
Awake,
Parton?
My child.
What?
The world has begun to turn inward upon itself. The sky will be above no longer. The earth below no longer. And mankind will be no more. Hurry, child, and arm yourself. Or else the world will be no more. Fear not and go forward in the name of the Great Mother, the Creator of all.
This whole game is like The Thing.
The hell out of me. Almost gave me a heart attack.
What's up, DeVal?
The yellow light again.
Yeah, we lost a little bit of HP. Is it a cat? You know, I forgot I had a new gun. Handgun. Automatic aiming. Limited ammunition. I got all the guns now. But I will definitely use a handgun on those stupid fucking birds.
We just had some company. I mean, I guess we're the company, but... You know that guy upstairs? His mother came over. She went up to the second floor and still hasn't come down. Even though her weirdo son seems to have wandered off. I don't know what she could possibly be doing up there by herself.
You want me to go look? Okay, fine, I'll go look. Open the door, hoe bag. Fine. I would.
Say, how do you think Kimberly is doing?
That's what happens when you ask Laura a question.
Say.
All right, out we go. Back into the snow. Laura? Oh, that's Laura. Alright, well, if she's up there, then we're gonna go to her house and steal all her stuff. Oh, David. No, that's Parker, I think. No, David's somebody else. All right, you little fucker. Three bullets in the handgun. That's all we got. Bird time. Bullshit. This game is a liar. I shot that bird right in its ass. Right in the booty. You're going nowhere. Bird time. Gotta get that meat.
Fuck birds.
Mm-hmm. I don't care about shooting no bunnies anymore. Fuck the dong birds the most. That's just what I do. Hey, Tilly. I like to play games that nobody's played. Not because nobody's played them, but because the ones nobody's played tend to be the weird ones. The unique ones. The creative ones. And the bad ones. Yep, just like in self-defense class, Abby. Give me that. Give me that. Give me that. Steal all Martha's grenades. What? I think Rocket wants some cat food. You want some cat food? You want some cat food? What do you want? You hungry? Yeah? You want me to get up and get you some cat food? Let's go get you some cat food, okay? You gotta say hello first. It's your interview time, alright? You hungry? You want some cat food? Yeah? Rocket. You want some cat food? Yeah? You hungry? You ready to place an order? You want the tender turkey? We don't give him tender turkey anymore. We give him the salmon. How you doing, Tori? You want the wild Alaskan salmon, huh? We changed to, what's that one? We changed to, what's it called? Fancy Feast. He loves the Fancy Feast. I get him like Purina Indoor Naturals for his dry food, and he gets the little containers of Fancy Feast wet food once a day. Nom 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 nom
nom nom nom nom nom nom nom nom nom nom. Cat food help.
Thank you for the cat food help. Friskies. No. He likes his Fancy Feast. I'll be right back. That's right. Fancy boy deserves a fancy feast. Hello, Coco. What is a Rhineland Crusader? Who's dying camel? Alright, I guess we're going back to the other house again. Back and forth we go. What? Have you seen the prices of chimneys these days? They're free. It's on the house. Oh, wow. I thought I'd told bad jokes. What's up, Leah 2? What do you call a clever duck? A wise quacker. I told my wife she was drawing her eyebrows too high. She looked at me surprised. I like that one because it gives you an image in your mind, you know? That's a long time, Coco. Shut up, birds. Nobody likes you. That's a mighty big eyeball you got there. Shame somebody shot it. Numbers 19 and 20 got into a fight. 21. War. this fucking bird. Yeah, I do it to pad the game length. I wanted to put some gameplay in with the adventure gaming. So walking and shooting the same. Why is there a snowmobile right there? Is Kimberly back? I'm guessing she is if the snowmobile's there. Now I can use the jankmobile instead of walking. Well, that's good, Leotude. What's going on, Parker?
Say,
how's Kimberly doing? Now I got a snowmobile, we can go faster. No more walking. Grove Street. You know what's funny? Well, my mom moved a couple years ago, but before that, she lived on Grove Street. It's true. All right, we're gonna skip this, skip that. No, no, no mama jokes. Got the jankmobile. I guess we're going to the bridge. Thing is so jank. Oh god. Holy shit. Interrupting my ride. It is too fast, yes. That's good, because normally it takes like 20 minutes to walk over here. Now it's gonna take like one. Really? The little one first. Good. Let's go. Finally, we're here and it's the right place to be.
Laura!
Kimmy!
Has Jenny come back yet? She's not out here either. If we could just open the damn gate, we could cross to the other side, but I guess there's nothing we can do now except go back into the house.
All right, let's turn around and go back then. Maybe it'll teleport me. Yay.
We still can't find Jenny. I'm really worried about her now. Did you find anything, Parker? Hey, is that a time bomb? That should take care of the gate. Set it to go off and say, well, it's from here to the stone bridge. 15 minutes should be long enough.
Hey, just hold on a minute. We haven't even tested this thing yet.
Test? Don't be such a wuss. Come on, hurry up. I have a gate to blow up.
All right. 1500. Okay, set to go off in 15 minutes.
Hopefully that's not.
Start cutting it too close.
1500 seconds.
Please, just how many, because it took you well, no, that would be fine too. Huh? On a snowmobile doesn't.
That'd be more than 15 minutes.
5 minutes. That's all I need. You want to bet me?
I don't play those kind of games.
Have it your way. Well, I'm impressed. Ooh, I wasn't sure you could do anything.
Give me a break.
Well, I'm off then. Be good. See you soon.
She gonna blow herself up.
What do you think of her? To tell you the truth, I had my doubts about her at one point. I thought maybe she'd already gone floral. turned into a monster already. I guess I was wrong. She's got a monster inside, all right. But it's a far more terrible kind. It's called loneliness. Everyone has a measure of it inside. But somehow she just can't learn how to keep it under control. And this loneliness is eating her up. Damn. Isn't there anything I can do for her? Maybe if I were a priest, I could offer her faith. If I were a warrior, I could protect her. I'm just me, and I can't offer her anything. It's been days since that crash, and hey, what time is it? Holy shit! I didn't set it for 15 minutes. I set it for 1,500 hours. Don't you see? I didn't set the thing to go off in 15 minutes. It's set for 3 p.m. There's only 5 minutes left. Kimberly! Wait, I...
Ruh-roh! I know we're gonna get a time limit. Oh god. The good news is I know how to get there. Is there gonna be monster fights along the way? The good news is I've been here so many fucking times with that being the wrong way to go. Then I know exactly how to get there. We're gonna get there in like 2 minutes or less. Way less. One minute, 9 seconds.
What's wrong, Laura? What do you think you're doing? We have to blow this gate. What on earth is going on?
Why didn't you throw it at the gate, Laura?
You said you wanted to help me. I was this close to getting killed. And if I had, it would have been all your fault.
I'm so sorry.
The Jankmobile.
Engineer. Yeah, right. Murderer is more like it. So you think you can just do what you please with my life? Is that it?
You have no idea how glad I am to see you.
Get out. It makes no difference to me whether you're here or not. Just get out of my sight.
She a man-hater.
Just get out of here.
We got another bomb. Let's go.
Sorry about that. Can you do me a favor? This is kind of my lucky charm. I think it's better for Kimberly to have it instead of me. If you don't mind, could you please give it to her? It was my fault. I was supposed to take care of her.
Uh-huh. Call your vault. Still locked. Martha's still up there doing God knows what with her son's dead body. Need to take a sleep. Skip. Oh. She's in here.
I'm sorry. I know it isn't his fault. But I just went off anyway. Can I tell you something? I lost my father when I was very young. He died and left nothing but a huge debt. Every day, the loan sharks would show up at the house, and every day, they would take it out on my mother. I'll never forget finding her that January morning. My mother killed herself. She put a bullet in her head. They showed up that day too, and then, when they realized they could never lay their dirty hands on her ever again, they came after me. I grabbed the revolver from my mother's hand and I fired at them. Then I escaped through the window and I ran away. And every night since, that morning has repeated in my dreams. Thing is, I started taking Linda to deal with my dreams.
Drugs.
I just can't deal with men anymore. I can't even face him in the same room. That's why when Parker said he just wanted to protect me, no man has ever said a thing like that to me before. I didn't know how to react, but I'm going to apologize to him in the morning. I know I can trust him. And this time, I'll stop pushing him away. I promise. Yeah. Sorry. Did I wake you? I'm, well, writing a poem. I thought I'd show it to Parker. Do you think he'll read it?
Stabbing pains throughout my body. Every time I move my head, every time I raise my arm, I get this constricting feeling. It's okay. It's okay. I'm fine. Thanks. Don't worry about me. Laura, I'm supposed to take care of you. But I
That's David. Whoever David is.
(Clears throat)
Morning, Laura. Parker, I'm sorry about last night.
Stay away from me. Look at this. I've somehow been infected. I'm still all right. I haven't blossomed yet. I'm still thinking straight. And I can make my own decisions for now. But it's only a matter of time, and I can't risk harming you two. I gotta go.
I guess.
You can't.
You'll be all right. You're not like the dinosaurs. You have this, and this too. Just know it's never too late. Being human means having free will, and the challenge is making the right choice. Nuclear power can be used to destroy cities or explore outer space. Drugs can be used to cure mental illness or escape from the world. The choices are yours. That's also true of what you do with your heart. Maybe humanity, every one of us as individuals, is being told it's time to grow up. I'll see you around. Don't die, either of you.
No, wait. Maybe we could still find a cure. There's no need for you to just leave like this.
Do you think you'll miss me when I'm no longer myself?
Yes, I will.
Will you remember me?
Of course.
Then just smile for me.
What?
Smile for me, Kimberly.
Like that song? Tupac song?
That's it. Come on, I know you can do it.
Oh, Parker.
I don't know if she can.
Thank you, Kimberly. You'll never be alone.
She finally loves a man, and he's a plant monster. Aww.
I went to sleep last night after I wrote that poem for him. I never slept so soundly without taking Linda. And I had this dream. I dreamt that I was crossing that bridge with Parker. And on the other side was a fresh new world. A totally new life. Laura, where's that other bomb? Did he?
Blow himself up? Better be a plant monster than a dirty cat.
Parker.
Good luck with your house, Abby.
Parker! Please answer me. I know you're here. It's not fair. You can't just leave me like this. Parker?
You just met him a couple days ago.
Parker.
No, please, Parker. No, it's not fair.
Jesus.
What is wrong with your face?
I weathered.
It's Parker's. Please, I need to be alone for a while.
We gonna go across the bridge. I'm excited. In just a second, I'll be right back. In the bathroom. Drop so many frames a day. I just noticed. I don't really notice. Okay. Bridge. Gonna take the Jankmobile across the bridge. But I can't. I'm stuck forever. I'm gonna soft lock the game. No, never mind. I didn't go. Wait, no. Dude. You can't go across the fucking bridge? Fuck. You can't back up. Can't walk, you can't, like, Jesus fucking Christ, you've got to be fucking kidding me, dude. Game is soft locked. I can't go across the bridge. For some fucking reason. I can't walk to the right here. There's a fucking invisible wall. And the snowmobile won't move because there's no reverse. I mean, you'd think the other button, you know, this would be reverse, you know, reverse, you know, the light comes on. No, that's the brakes. Other buttons, both buttons. Nothing. It's just fucking stuck forever. I can't step over the log. I can't walk past the invisible wall. No. I can't even... You can't do shit. It's fucking soft locked. Fuck me. Yeah, I want to watch all that shit again. I want to watch all that shit again. Dude, we've got like half an hour of fucking cutscenes. Plus, you know, a couple of trips on the snow. Just fuck me, dude. Non-skippable. Non-skippable cutscenes. I'm gonna get my food and watch these cutscenes while I eat. Back in a few.
Has Jenny come back yet?
Thank you.
Okay, I'm on my way. Just kidding, there's too much dirt out there. We're back. Now, every time you get on, before you get on the snowmobile, you must save the game. Or else you have a possibility of losing the snowmobile forever. And I can't go across the bridge. Okay. Back to shooting birds. My favorite. Can you fucking stop, dude? Dude, I'm gonna fucking die. Fuck off. Seriously! This playthrough has been a fucking shit show. I mean, I've wasted hours. Hi, Jimmy. World record pace. Oh, yeah. Maestro's clones and ability for Velma from Scooby-Doo to call the cops on LeBron James. Why though? Should have gave the jank mobile the ability to back up. Fixes this game. Probably the first person to ever soft lock the fucking stupid jank mobile.
Oh, Laura, help me. I've been hiding because I was so scared. Kimmy was acting weird to
me. I'm on disc 3 out of 4.
And that man upstairs too. She...
You... It was you two who did that to my boy! To my Tom! Little monsters... Was it fun torturing him? I saw how you treated him. You fed on him, didn't you? Did he taste good? How did my little boy taste? Come. I'll treat this little one like you did my son.
Why do you have wings?
I'll eat her down to the bone and enjoy every last bite.
How, Pixels? No, I didn't. That fucking hurt.
Tom, can you hear me? Tom,
Tom, let's play a game. Tom, can you hear me? Tom, can you hear me? I wasn't there. Was I? Tom, can you hear me?
Quit dancing around. She did. Weird Japan, Pixels. That's what this game is.
I wanted so much to play a duet with you, Tom. Please forgive me.
Fuck birds.
Laura, I'm so scared. That's what Kimmy did. She wasn't a monster, but she... I went upstairs because the door was open and I saw Kimmy and she was...
What is wrong with your face?
Then Kimmy saw me. And she started chasing me too. That's why I went and hid.
So that's what's been happening. Oh, God. I don't remember anything, but if Jenny says so, I must have... Laura, I'm gonna find Parker and be with him. I'm not alone anymore.
He's dead?
Loneliness. No. Not anymore. Yeah. I wish I hadn't lived to do these things. But until just a few days ago, I had nothing to even regret losing. If I could go back in time and see myself the way I was, I would give her a hard slap across the face. Then I'd take her to meet you and Parker. And I would tell her, these are your friends, starting today. Laura, I've changed my mind. If I could just have another chance at life, I'd like to be reborn as myself. And I'd like to have you as my friend again. Promise? Would you be? Thank you. Thank you. I'm going now.
Well, in the first game, it stands for Dracula.
Don't turn around, please.
It turns out your dad is Dracula.
You need to see me off. Remember, this isn't goodbye. We're friends. Friends for life.
I don't think there's any Dracula in this game, though. Friends for life. Got it. Alright. Now... we're going to learn our lesson and save constantly. And take a nap. I don't think so. I mean, the stories are completely unrelated in all the games.
ever dance with the devil in the pale moonlight?
Hanny, what's up? Thanks for 20 months. How you doing? How's it going? The funniest thing about D is that there's different endings. And in one of the endings, Dracula, your dad, eats you. And during the credits, you hear him eating you. Which is hilarious. I mean, it's the same Laura, but it's like a parallel universe or some shit, you know, like I'm Laura in all of them. And Kimberly and Parker were in the last game, but it was in space. It has nothing to do with this whatsoever. And David was too in Enemy Zero. First game only had Laura. Second game had Laura, Parker, Kimberly, David. It is. They call Laura a digital actress. So, you know, it's like a movie with, you know, the same actress, but a different story, right? That's their explanation. Well, they're plant people from outer space. Came on a meteor. Jenny.
I don't know what to do. Laura, don't ever leave me alone, okay?
It's true.
Please.
But not green ones. Okay, bye. Oh, shit. It's an Easter egg. Oh, and there's a cult, too. Don't forget about the cult. Spinach spaghetti. That's a thing. Easter egg, sir. Ziggy, 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 zig. That dude has almost as many piercings as Abby. Where we going? to my worst nightmare, the Stone Bridge. Which is now clear.
Laura, is Parker really dead?
I heard everyone talking.
Look, it's Parker!
Laura.
You don't look so good. Well, now you can be together forever.
First there was light, and what lay between the stars was called
Gordon Darkness.
Adrift even from sorrow, the survivors turn letters from the sun to ashes. Gordon Darkness, from the inkwell of their veins, the survivors took to weaving words of abomination. The words spoke not of the heart. The words instead armored the soul. And the survivors made a fortress of their folly. On the first day, they made fire to burn the sky. On the second day, they made fire to burn the sea. On the third day, they made fire to burn the earth. On the fourth day, they made fire to burn the stars. On the fifth day, there was nothing. On the sixth day, there was emptiness.
So I count the roses.
And on the seventh day, you appeared. You unchained the cage of things forbidden, and the darkness began to change. Strength began to course, and the strength beget power. You swept a boat out into the swelling river and guided me across on a link of thoughts, heedless of the water's fearful source, severed from the markers of time. The smothering solitude thawed in your light and became a rising tree on a forgiving hill. The tree begat a forest, and the forest called forth winged creatures, then traced the contour of a heart as they flew, reconstructing brightness long since forgotten. They overflow, fall from the sky, murmuring their light, crystallize. In the verdance of the trees, gather what falls from the sky, you cried. Fly, you cried. Fly, you cried. Fly, you cried.
I haven't played it.
And when the gods arrived, as life finally came to an end, as it started, they saw boundless joy, and they knew it was your doing. What you guarded in their stead is the brightness that shines within. What you guarded in their stead, I shall call love. And understand at last that first there was light.
Guess I don't really like to have fun.
Laura.
David.
Do you know who you are? You must learn the truth, for the evil one is giving himself to a fear for power even now. And together they shall become the shadow. Laura, you are the chosen one. You must awake.
I don't think it's over. Progression? What do you mean? It has a beginning, an end, and a middle. That's right.
Laura, listen to me.
Jank mobile game.
Can't hold on much longer.
Okay, that's David.
I'm not gonna make it. Not with his injury. Don't look at me like that. It's okay, Laura. I'm not afraid of dying now. Laura, I want you to do something for me. Leave me here and go. You've got to stay alive. There's nothing more I can do. I'm all... Please, Laura, don't look so sad. You have no idea how happy I've been spending my last days with you. You kept me going. That's why, more than anything else in the world.
It wasn't irreversible, was it?
The moment I saw you on that plane, I knew I had to keep you safe. I don't know why, but I just knew I had to. That's why you've got to survive. All I can offer now is to leave you with a smile. I wish I had something you could take with you. But I...
Oh, look at that. Disc 4. You got 182 to go. It's my mom's laboratory. What the fuck?
You don't want to lose it. It's a precious gift from your mother, Laura.
Earn it the Russian way.
Parton Laboratory. Parton. That's the same last name as yours, Laura.
This is the Lucy Parton Laboratory.
What is wrong with your face?
The entire facility has been shut down. Only authorized personnel are permitted access. This is the Lucy Parton Laboratory.
Shut up and let me in, Hal.
The entire facility has been shut down. Only authorized personnel are permitted access. Please state your name. Please state your name.
This is... Laura. Laura Parton.
Finally, she said something. First time in the game. What's up, Yoga Pants?
Have you been here before?
Back to silent, Laura.
It's freezing in here. I'm a little cold.
I can't let you do that, Laura.
DNA scan completed. Laura Parton, please enter. Laura Parton's last visit was 27 years ago. Your associate is not cleared for access. Please wait here.
I'm your number one fan.
Little nibble is all I need. Nom nom food.
I'll wait for you here.
I'll give you a little nibble. Thank you, Abby.
I know you'll come back.
appreciate the 20 bucks. We gonna get there. One day. And I'm making General So's tempeh, I tell you what. This game is Weird Japan the game. And it's the sequel to D. Wow, you're smart.
Laboratory, I would like to welcome you to the visitor center. Please press any button for the information you desire.
I think I can turn this game down now that Kimberly's not here, because Kimberly was the quietest talking bitch in the game. Tell me about the laboratory. The laboratory.
This facility houses the Lucy Parton Laboratory of the LPL Corporation and includes the Research and Development Division. The facility, which was moved here to Ultramarine City in 1971, consists of four separate wings. The Visitor Center, which also serves as the showroom. The main laboratory, where the actual research is conducted. The Parton Tower office complex. And the library, where all data is archived.
Uh-huh. Tell me about the LPL Corporation.
The Lucy Parton Laboratory of the LPL Corporation was established by the Parton family in 1963. The primary objective of establishing this facility was to continue the research work in molecular biology and genetic engineering, particularly the field of cloning technology, initiated by then chief executive of the LPL Corporation and director of research, Dr. Lucy Parton. The cloning project was discontinued in 1974, several months after Dr. Parton was seriously injured in a laboratory accident. However, the facility continued to conduct research on agricultural applications of genetic engineering under a government grant until 1981. The genetic engineering technology researched and developed here by the LPL Corporation is still helping to feed the world by increasing the nutritional content of certain types of livestock and grain. Since 1981, only the Visitor Center wing has functioned as a showroom for molecular biotechnology and genetic engineering. All proceeds from the center are channeled to various university research funds.
Let me check. No spots open.
Dr. Lucy Parton, chief executive of LPL Corporation and director of the Lucy Parton Laboratory, was born in 1932 in Chicago, Illinois. After a brilliant and much accelerated academic career, she and her father, the well-known entrepreneur and former LPL chairman, Roy Parton, founded the Lucy Parton Laboratory in 1957, an institute dedicated to research in molecular biology, particularly the then-fledgling field of genetic engineering. Lucy Parton is especially well known for her work on mammoth cell cloning, a project that began in 1963 with the discovery of a perfectly preserved woolly mammoth found in the subarctic permafrost. Dr. Parton also left lasting marks in other fields, such as medicine and agriculture, before her life and work were cut short in 1973 by a research-related accident. All All data concerning this technology has been erased.
I doubt that.
Laura Parton, a level D+ key has been issued in your name. You may access the main laboratory.
Level D+, baby! Loudest elevator door ever. Is that a dove on the wall there? The one that attacked that boss a long time ago? Hello, Mother Computer.
You've come very far, Laura. I am Lucy, your mother. I've been waiting for you. Laura, I'm right here. I know that you've come very far, my beloved Laura. It all began 38 years ago, with a genetic memory, asleep in a wall of Arctic ice. In 1963, I began working on a special project using cloning technology to bring mammoths back from extinction. My team discovered a perfectly preserved mammoth specimen in the winter permafrost of northern Canada in 1971. And we were able to extract genetic material from the cell nucleus. Unfortunately, there was too much chromosome damage. But we found something else. In the stomach of that frozen mammoth, we found the undigested remains of a totally unknown organism. Mammoths were believed to be herbivores, but this one, anyway, had apparently eaten another creature. And what a creature! It looked human, but had a pair of wings sprouting from its back. We removed him. Yes, the creature was male, from the stomach for further study. Then I decided that we would extract a sperm specimen and attempt fertilization, using my ovum and in my womb.
What?
I decided to give birth to a hybrid child.
What?
Fathered by this winged human.
What?
The fertilization was successful, but the embryo developed without a trace of wings. That made no difference to me. The child was the fulfillment of my dreams. A miraculous collaboration between me and that being we found inside the mammoth. The baby was born in the early hours of December 31st, under the most spectacular display of Aurora Borealis that winter. It was born across that span of time. I took the first letter of my given name and added the Latin word for air, aura, and named the child Laura. It's true. That was how you entered this world, Laura.
What the fuck?
When I was in labor with you, I had a vision. Something akin to the will of the cosmos spoke to me and described something important. That a powerful spirit had appeared in the space-time continuum and was on its way to Earth from the far reaches of space, and that it would arrive on Earth when my child had become a grown woman. At that moment, for the first time, I felt the enormity, even the sin, of what I had done. But at the same time, I saw in you the hands of fate. Then, 7 days later, my own life ended. But others at this institute and the government wanted to repeat the experiment. They wanted to bring those winged human beings of prehistoric times back to life. They transferred my mind and will to this, to Xylo. But without a compatible ova or a willing surrogate in which to bring the embryo to term, their efforts ended in failure. Look. Laura, you must kill me. End your mother's torment so that no one will ever repeat this mistake. Do it now, while I still have my will.
Hi, pirate. What the fuck?
Laura. Please kill me. Please kill me, Laura. Laura, please. Please.
Okay.
Kill me. Laura, kill me. Kill me.
How's that?
Kill me! Kill
me! Want another one?
Kill me! Kill me! Kill me! Kill me!
You want another one?
Laura, please, kill me.
I don't think that one did anything. Okay, shut up. Kill the vagina. You don't belong in this world. I'm not surprised there's a computer vag in this fucking game.
Laura Parton.
Hi, Lila.
The evil one has joined himself to a fearful power and has been remade. The evil one knows you, my child, and shall seek you out. Go forward, Laura. You must not stop, no matter what.
He's dead, Thunderplayer. He's not okay. He's dead. He's, yeah. Guy who directed this game and D and Enemy Zero. Save the game. Wait, where are we? Talk or call Peaks? No? Wait. I don't think we're on the map. It doesn't show us on the map. Alright. I'll get to the bathroom. One sec. Jenny!
doing here? I want to go home. I want to go home now. It feels all wrong here. Hey, Laura, I discovered something. What matters most is time. I had a dream. There were big dinosaurs walking around. And then lots of people making buildings in the desert. There were some people on a ship crossing a big ocean. Then people were shooting at each other with guns. I saw big trees being chopped down and jet fighters in the sky. And then a really big, big explosion. There was a space rocket going straight up and astronauts hopping up and down on the moon. And animals getting shots in a lab. A big wave of water came and washed away a town. And a whole mountain caught on fire. There was something that looked like a forest, but it was all missiles instead of trees. It was kind of like when you fast forward a long movie. But I knew it wouldn't go the other way. And I thought that's what's really important. Time is the only thing that can't go back. It's kind of like a lesson. Like Grandpa teaches me.
Gonna blossom.
Oh, Laura, I think I'm getting sick. Laura, I can't talk. Laura, I'm scared. Please.
She's a robot.
I'm scared.
Laura. She's a T-1000.
What is wrong with your face?
Laura, get up, Laura. You must climb a mountain that awaits you to the north and make the fearsome power your own. You must become one with that power. Only then can you save your world and I.
Why did she melt? I don't understand. I'm going to bed. Wake up from this nightmare. All right, well, I guess it's time to climb a mountain. Save constantly. Death Mountain now. We're going to Death Mountain. This is fucking Zelda. Off to Death Mountain. Like, I need first aid spray. I haven't used a first aid spray in this game yet. I shot enough birds and bunnies. Back to the shooting. Ooh, first aid spray. Doesn't look like there's any bunnies on Death Mountain. Bleach. That's a bunch of them. Y'all are getting the grenade. Y'all can just piss right off. Not. This meat's coming in handy now. God, you're so annoying. We got a free heal out of it. It's a good time to save the game. Glorville of our enemies. Yep. Alright, if he hops, he's gonna hop back, so don't follow him. Not a bird. Fuck me. Pull the fucking thing out. It's shotgun time. Hello, Bun. You missed a lot. You should watch the VOD, though. There was some crazy shit going on. I think we're making the final journey to the end of the game now. Yay, two birds. Well, I got my shotgun out. I missed. I'm gonna fucking die. Please die. God, stop!
Fuck birds.
I killed my mother. She was a computer vagina. Care about items. Get out of here. Yeah, fuck you. Okay.
Your mind makes it real.
The birds are annoying. And my kid friend melted into the ground for some reason. That's him. Gotta eat all my meats. Yep, we're all caught up. Oh, and Parker turned into a plant and impaled Kimberly, and Kimberly hugged him and shot him with a shotgun, and they both died together. Oh, and I soft locked by running the snowmobile into a bridge, and it doesn't have a backup function, so I couldn't do anything. I got the snowmobile stuck, and I had to load and rewatch half an hour of cutscenes. Fun. Ooh, ugly. No birds? Fucking easy. Birds, super fucking hard. Going up there. We're going to Death Mountain, just like in Zelda. No birds. Fuck you. Oh, I got his ass. Fuck off. Christ, man. So bad. Oh, please just get there. Hi, Drake. No birds. So it's extremely easy. It's either birds, extremely difficult, or no birds, extremely easy. That's your only choices. I want to use a shotgun. What wife? I had a wife in a video game one time, okay? It was an e-wife. Sounds Devin, what's going on? We're about to finish D2. You're right on time. Probably gonna finish. I mean, I don't know what the fuck else. It can't be anything else, right? We're climbing to Death Mountain. Look over there. That's Death Mountain up there. I'm doing good. A waifu. Waifu has to be Asian. I don't know how many shotgun shells I have. Probably plenty. Not plenty. Well, we're almost there. Climbing to piss in the eye of Sauron. It's an Easter egg, okay? Somebody painted an egg red, and it's an Easter egg. Sauron's Vag. No. Come on, no more enemies. It's right here. Come on, just stop the enemies. Oh, no birds. Alright, no birds. Finishing it right now. Get back, Satan! Watch that Amazon show and like, and I want to like it just so I can tell Ben how good it is. Yay, shotgun shells. Be like, it's a great show, Ben. You should watch it. It's fucking awesome. Did you watch it? Can we stop? Done with your random battles. So done. Why do you hit me? Why do you hit me? Stop! You die. That sounds good. I'm all out of meat. All right, Sauron's Vag, let's enter. Seriously? Save the game. I was one step away from the fucking cutscene. Mother computer vagina.
And Laura, know the planet you inhabit. Know the time you move through it. Awaken the memories that sleep within you. Laura, you must know and feel everything. This is Mother Earth. This is your home.
For only $1 a day.
Laura, how many days has
you
it been?
You've been, I put.
Time just seems to fade into the distance for me.
Did
now.
You block Nightbot?
It's strange. But I don't feel sad. The snow will soon cover my body. Time will cease to exist. And I'll disappear under the thickening layer of snow. And in that whiteness, all this will transform itself into water and earth.
Were you drunk?
Over a longer period of
fuck
time,
this Nightbot guy! Block!
And maybe one day, I'll come back again as a very small flower. I'll blossom
what?
And grow. There's an interesting thought for you, Laura, don't you think? Me as a plant? I've never so much as even had a plant in my apartment. Now I'm on my way to being reincarnated as one. Just think. Someday, someone may walk past me. They may be laughing or crying when they do. Or they may be full of hope. Or in deep despair.
This guy reminds me of the Deadly Premonition guy.
But it won't matter to me then. Because a flower doesn't care what it has or doesn't have. Just is protruding from the snow, waving in the breeze. But it's different with you, Laura. You must survive.
Yeah, just the main guy from Deadly Premonition.
I'll be staying here.
I forget his name now.
Thinking of you.
But he talks to Zach.
Dreaming of you. Laura.
FK in the coffee.
It's okay. You can do it. If anyone can, it's you.
There you go. Thank you, Nate. I need to play part two. Oh! Let me kill him! Let me kill him!
Fool, do you think you can stand in my way?
Hi, Mahoney.
All that exists shall follow.
It happens every once in a while, Mahoney.
Your human race, and even this planet. Is no exception. The will of the cosmos will not be denied.
I don't know. I don't trust people's opinions about that type of thing, Ben.
Grown old without growing wise. And this planet, not content with its first folly, it creates a second, even more foolish, dominant species. All this shall be destroyed.
Called me a boomer?
Go now. Get out. How dare you challenge my power?
Who was it? Would you like a grenade, sir? Georgian Dake? I have no idea who that is.
Then a fool
You That's what I was wondering, Nate. Fuck, your dad is fucking Dracula. That's hilarious. I talk shit about the prequels every once in a while. He must have been lurking. He never spoke in my chat before. Well, that didn't do anything. How about this? The pistol auto-aims, so... Thank you, Mahoney. That's pretty good. I like it. That's all the handgun we got. We'll try another grenade. I know, I need to shoot that guy, probably. Wait, it doesn't... Oh, it does show my health. I was like, wait a minute. I'm supposed to be shooting this thing. Kinda. Did he just poop?
Your eyes, you will see this world no more. Never more.
Quoth the raven? It now, that's good. It just seems like it's a time limit because he just like hits you and then waits a while and hits you and waits a while. We're doing damage now though, that's good. Is there something I'm supposed to be doing here? No, just wait. Let me shoot you. Can't do anything. Oh, wait. I mean, what the fuck am I supposed to be doing? Oh, just shoot. Okay. Just shoot into the darkness.
that, I will take your ears, and these words will be the last.
No, not my, not me ears. Right? Alright, well, we'll just hold down the button, I guess. I should heal. Nope, no meats. I mean, we're hurting him. Well, I don't hear the boss anymore. He took me ears and my eyes, and I'm shooting into the darkness. It's a great boss fight. This is art, ladies and gentlemen. Can I have my ears back, at least? I'm gonna take my tongue now. Let's just do this one. All right, good. It's gonna take a while, apparently. This is fucking weird. It sure is. I'm not hitting it. Okay. You mean Linda? Emily?
How do you feel now?
Hey.
Grovel in fear.
I don't want to grovel.
First you are blind. Then you are deaf. And now you will move no longer. Do you understand what that means? Death. It means death. The
not
certain
deaf.
Death that is yours, and you will be lost in the vast abyss for all eternity.
No. Can we not do that? Can't do anything. Nothing. Okay. Good game. And Frank Simulator.
Laura.
Yes, David?
I guess it's time to say goodbye. Oh, Laura, don't be sad. You'll be all right. It's okay. You'll be able to make it through.
Hi, Lex.
And look. I have something special to give you. Here it is. I hope you'll think of me every time you look at it. I've put it away in your keepsake. Laura, don't forget me.
Okay.
David.
David. Got it.
I guess it's that time. Oh, well. Good
Bye, David. I don't have a key. Oh, there it is. I knew it was going to be an item eventually.
What's happening? My body. My mind. Stop it.
David's computer's vanished. It might take a while, Artie.
Not possible.
Laura. Now.
Okay. I'm ready. I'm ready. Fuck it up! Yeah! About fucking time! Had enough of your bullshit! Stupid fucker! Get out of here! At least it's unique, Bud.
Laura. 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 Can you hear me? The evil here has been destroyed. You can move again now. Laura, the time has come for you to bond with that fearsome power. Though you cannot see, nor can you hear, you must slowly go forward, my child, one step at a time. And with this new power, this unknown force, you will bring salvation. You, Laura, will save your world. Feel the earth underfoot, my child. Awaken the sleeping memory of your wings. And believe in the power that lies in the palm of your hands.
Bye, Artie.
That power will grant you miraculous things. Now go, my child. Laura, child of destiny, born across the shores of time. Listen well, my child. You do not know that this apparently endless universe does not have an end. That time, so infinite to misleading senses, will one day stop. You know so little, for you are but a child, a newborn. You must journey forth again, and this voyage will be far longer and much more terrifying. Now is the time to find him. Do you remember? Do you remember the name of the one who saved you?
David.
It was he who safeguarded your soul. Go and find him, and thus forge that power at last into one. Laura, my child, call his name. Speak his name, so that all lives and all that will be born shall be saved. Call him and recreate yourself as you were meant to be.
I appreciate so much that this screen is gray and not fucking bright-ass white. Like, thank you. I can actually look at this and I'm not fucking blind.
David.
I had to push the button to say it. I knew it. How do you both say the same fucking thing? It fell out of the sky again for the third time in the game. Where's me wings? I want wings. Those children aren't going to melt too, are they? You look a little different there. It's David.
You, dropped this. Here. You wouldn't want to lose it, Laura. Oh, I'm sorry. I couldn't help seeing your name on this. And besides, I feel like we've met before. Well. Hey, that book you have. You read Kimberly Fox? I've read some of her work. I've never met anyone else who's even heard of her. She isn't widely recognized. At least, not yet. My favorite piece in this book is...
What is wrong with your face?
There's nothing wrong with his face.
Light. It's about a sort of hypothetical woman, the poet's imaginary best friend. This woman is... Oh, I get it now. That's why I felt like we'd met before. Ah, you remind me of her. For me, if that sounds strange, but, well, it is strange. I highly recommend it. It's a wonderful poem. Everything Kimberly Fox writes is so filled with hope and love of life. Oh, Laura, look.
Hmm?
So beautiful. Well, anyway, I guess I'll be going.
David!
He's like, you crazy bitch. No. Did he call the cops? That's true. Y2K. Happy New Year, Andred.
Y2K.
Whoop. Thanks, Hunter Player. And dinosaurs. And the meteor coming to kill him. CRPGs. Might and Magic 2. Dungeons and Dragons, Secret of the Silver Blades, and Dragon Wars, and Cavemen. And Romans. Or something. Yeah, it's Rome. No, that's Egypt, isn't it? Thank you, Davkin. How you doing? The problem isn't in understanding it. The problem is that they've got multiple different themes going on that aren't related. I think that thing with the book in the bookstore was about, like, they were trying to explain why Laura's in all the games. It's like a parallel universe kind of thing. Like, in this universe, Kimberly Fox is an author of a book called Universe. And the book said something about Laura's character, like, the poet's something, muse or something. Then we've got Stonehenge predicting meteorites, plant people, and... There's a lot going on. I think it's going to turn into an environmental message. Stop destroying yourself, humans. Thank you. Who knows why the kid melted? Right? The Berlin Wall coming down. Shock and awe. Smart fruit. Oh, is that what happened? Cutting down to rainforest. Failed Laura clone. No idea. I think it must have been something that was cut because they had the brooch. The little girl's brooch, which should have meant something, I think. I think they cut something out. Well, it's got four disc button. That's why they can put so much video on it. Sad moon rising. But yeah, they didn't make any of that video, Baden. That's all like from history and historical stuff. You can find all that on you know, old archives of video. They didn't make any of that. They just put it together. Earth, okay. I like this guy a lot better than Kojima. What? AIDS? What the fuck? Why? Why are we talking about AIDS now? Okay. Yes. Is he going to start talking about COVID? Oh, starving people, AIDS. Kid melted from AIDS. Starving children. Illiterate people. And most of them are in my chat. Who gives a shit? Maybe they're happy without electricity. Oh, the children. Well, that's good. We got some good facts now. Hi, Joe. Bumps it up a star. Oh, no, not the rainforest. Uh-oh, I told you it was going to be an environmental thing. Uh-oh, carbon dioxide. You say the voices of Laura's head from AIDS. Plant species. Yeah, Laura killed most of them. Fish, okay. Fish. Birds, all right. Do you know how many birds have gone extinct before recorded history? You know, they're making more species, right? They're making more, so, like, it's okay. There's going to be more. There's not a finite number of species. There's going to be more of them coming. It's okay. There's 28 million kittens purred happily. Okay. Oh, what an end. We did it! We finished D and Enemy Zero and D2, finally. All because Delicious Coffee bugged me to play something on Dreamcast. What? Thanks, guys. Good game. Many, many roses wrap me warm. Oh, and Kenji Eno did all the music, except for this song. Roses wave and roses grow. They get their rhythm right. Counting the Roses by Arto Lindsay. Yeah, we had a big part in that, but, like, species going extinct is all just our own. We want to keep animals for selfish reasons. You know, we're sentimental about it, right? More species have gone extinct in the past than exist now, and more will be extinct, and then more will be born, you know? It's just a natural fucking process. That's a lot of people, Lila. Diablo 2. I don't want species to go extinct, but it's perfectly fucking a normal, natural process of the universe. Topia serial murder case. No, what is that? Is it an adventure game? Sounds like an adventure game. Directed, produced, music, story, Kenji Eno. I always play good games like this, Baden. Oh, that's by Kenji Eno. Let's see. I guess there's a fan translation, huh? Maybe. There's a video of a fan translation. Is that what time my Dreamcast has? On the battery? Probably. Well, I would play it. But, you know, I'd have to figure out, like, PC 6001 emulation or something. Yeah. Well, that's what time it is. Oh, 760 days until the 21st century. I'm not so sure about that. This is what time it is on my Dreamcast, apparently. I didn't set the date right, you know. Diversity, not numbers, yeah. Lapse and reform, yep. Rocket. Hello? You don't want to look over here? Rocket. Yeah, you hear me. You know I'm talking to you. That tail gives it away. Rocket. Rocket. Yeah. Let's see what else we got here. 760 days until the 21st century. Not exactly. But okay, is that it? We're done? Is that it? We beat it? We're done? Okay. The day's over, Bash. It's all over. You can't have any more. I guess we can have some more cat then. Oops. He is huge. He's a big old kitty. Big monster, aren't you? It was possibly the weirdest game I've ever played. Was that the weirdest game I've ever played? I don't know. I played a lot of weird fucking games. Has to be, right? Oh no, not Bash's D. Alright, well, you know, with a cutscene that long, that means I really need to go to the bathroom and have for a very long time now.